Oh my gosh. Guys, do me a favor. I need y'all to go follow me on Instagram right now. Damian Crier Sr., all lower casings. Y'all want to see me continue exposing these gold diggers. This chick looking real fly walking the sidewalk with this red hair. I'm going to see what she on. And she got a bad banging figure too on her. Let's see what's up with her. Hey, beautiful. How you doing?
Hey.
What's your name?
Anna,
I'm Damian. Goodness, you are beautiful. Are you single? You got a man? You married?
Single.
How'd that happen?
Things happen.
I mean, you got MySpace or anything? Or
MySpace? I mean, I got Instagram.
Can I follow you? Mm-hmm. You sure? I mean, you ain't gonna get me shot out here. It's harder for me to believe somebody like you single.
I don't know.
You don't know? So what's your Instagram? If you want to type it in for me. Check you out. So you just out here just walking around?
No, I wanted to meet with some homegirls.
Oh, okay. Some homegirls. Cool. So, I mean, so you single, like so you on the market?
I don't know. Where do you work?
Where I work? Shoot, you see what I'm representing. I'm representing a hardworking man, like all men should.
I mean, that's my job when I was like 15, so I don't know.
Well, it's my job at 53.
53?
And I love it. Yeah, them french fries, them burgers, them milkshakes and stuff, you know they popping.
Yeah, I don't know anymore.
Is it because of where I work at?
Yeah. Oh. But thank you, though.
Okay, well, it's sorry to bother you.
Yeah.
You take care of yourself. Bye. Beautiful. Wow, bye, huh? All right. Something about, they don't want to mess with nobody working at McDonald's. I don't see nothing wrong. It's a good, clean job. They got good french fries and stuff. Well, everybody's different, I guess. Oh, yo, come here. Oh, she came back. Yo, what's up? You came back. What's going on?
This your car?
Yeah, this one of my cars. Why?
One of your cars?
Yeah, one of them. Yeah. Why? What's going on?
Oh, well, I didn't know you made this much.
Of course you didn't know. Yeah.
Are you like the manager or what are you?
No, I'm not the manager. I actually work at 3 McDonald's, to be honest with you. Oh. I go from one to the other, one to the other. I'm not a manager. I'm actually the owner.
Okay.
And I dress like this because I don't just watch my employees work. I actually jump right in there with them to work.
Well, sure. Then we can talk then.
We can talk then.
Yeah.
You was just on the sidewalk, right?
Yeah, I was there.
Oh, so what, you don't like guys who work at McDonald's or something? You don't think that can provide a person like a good way of living?
Yeah, you can't. I actually like fries, so I like fries smell, so it's all right.
Oh, so do I smell like fries to you?
A little bit.
Oh, you look very beautiful. Can I check you out? Can I get a little spam from you? That's all you?
Yes.
Oh, my God. You ever been inside a Rolls Royce before?
Never.
Okay, I mean, you got a few minutes?
Yes.
Let me get the door for you. Don't be lying talking about you ain't got no dude getting this shot.
I'm single.
You from Houston?
Yes.
Born and raised?
Brownsville, Texas.
Okay,
but I'm here in Houston now.
Careful getting up in there.
Oh, wow, it's beautiful.
Exactly. And you look good sitting
red
up in there.
My hair.
Exactly. Okay. She came back, bro. Let's see what she on real quick with her fine. Yeah, she fine. You getting comfortable over there?
Perfect. It's hot out there, so this is
good. I'm going to turn this up a little bit because it is kind of blazing.
I like the interior. It matches me, I would look really good in here.
You definitely do. You definitely look good. And that hair is banging on you. Banging. So tell me about yourself. You said that you from Brownsville.
Brownsville, Texas, but I stay in Houston.
Mm-hmm. How long have you been out here?
Like 20 years.
20?
Yeah.
So you obviously love it out here.
Yeah, I love Houston.
Out of such a beautiful girl like you, just be single. Like, what is that all about? Like, keeping your options open as well?
Yeah. Keeping it really open, see what comes around.
Okay. You got kids?
Yes.
Okay.
So, but, you know, I know how to maintain myself and everything.
Okay.
I'm a nurse assistant.
Oh, wow. Good. So you work every day and stuff?
Yes. I work every night.
Okay. Oh, every night. So you work the night shift.
Night shift. Yes, sir.
People on a day shift don't know what they mess
they
up.
They do not know.
So you be looking like that at work? I mean,
no.
Yo, I'm well. I guess what I'm saying, like your nurse outfit, it really fits you. Like yeah. It really shows.
Yeah, you I have my scrubs covered up. They don't know who I am out here though.
I bet them patients. I bet them patients been in bed like, oh,
heart attack.
Please take my blood pressure. Please take my blood pressure.
Something like that.
Okay, okay. So let me ask you something. So you said that your name was what again?
Anna.
Anna, okay. And it's right on your neck too, Anna.
Yes.
Again, I'm Damien. So I want to ask you a question. And just be honest, you won't offend me.
Yes.
What made you really come back to the car? Like, just be honest.
The car.
Car. Yeah, the car. Rolls Royce. You like inside of cars?
Yes. And I've never been in one before, ever, ever, ever.
Okay, so what do you think? Stars in the sun?
Oh, I didn't even see that.
Yeah.
Beautiful. It's beautiful.
No longer.
Yeah, I love the red in here. I love the red in here.
That's something. You don't have to go to the park and lay in the grass to see the stars. No. You can just sit in the car and look up. It's pretty dope, huh?
Yeah, I love it.
Okay. Well, since you was honest with me, Anna, and I do appreciate your honesty. You know, I'm not really offended because the car, it is a woman attractor. Mm-hmm. It's a magnet. But I want to be honest with you since you was honest with me. Carry your cell phone with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you pull it out so I can...
Oh, well, actually, I left it over there in my car. Yeah, I don't have it.
Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, so I know you probably wonder where I'm going with the cell phone. So I asked you earlier if you had kids, and I didn't say kid. I said kids with an S, and you said yes.
Yes.
And I'm sure that your kids love you.
Dearly, yes.
You got your parents in your life, relatives?
Yes, I'm both parents.
Aunties and uncles that love you?
Yes.
Okay, the reason I asked you about your cell phone, you know, like, are you familiar with Amber Alert?
Oh, yeah. All the time. Going off all the time. It's so sad.
What do you remember about them? Like, what are they about?
The you know, babies getting kidnapped, stuff like that.
Babies. So how old are you?
30.
30? You still a baby yourself. When you see those Amber Alerts go off on your phone and it says that a child has been abducted or kidnapped, it's not just children, it's people your age, 20, 30, beautiful young women. And a lot of times people would use stuff to lure people into their vehicles, to kidnap them, exotic cars, Rolls Royces. And being young and beautiful, of course, you're going to be attracted to nice things, like what attracted you to this car.
Yeah.
You know, and like Texas is one of the number one places in the world that's known for human trafficking and kidnapping. And what happens is when they kidnap you, they take you to other countries, drug you out, prostitute you, they sell you to other people, and then eventually you lose your life.
That's true.
And then your children that you have at home, your right. parents that love you, they're hurt because you're no longer here. You know,
right.
But you've been young, you got a good career going for you, and I'm sure I just have a feeling that you're the type of person that's going to forward your education.
Oh, of course.
And the last thing I ever want to see is that Amber Alert come across my phone, and it's you. And I seen you walking down the sidewalk, and it didn't even stop you to say something to you. So the reason why I stopped you is really because I wanted to talk to you about Amber Alerts. And, you know, I'm trying to really raise awareness because people don't take these Amber Alerts serious. They look at them because it's a loud noise in their text and they don't want to they'll just ignore it. But, you know, those are real people.
You're right.
That's really missing.
You're completely right. And it can be babies or adults. You're right.
Yeah. And by me telling you this right here, I'm hoping that you would share it with somebody. Because.
Definitely.
You better actually save someone's life, somebody that you don't even know, because it's real out here. It's a bunch of creeps out here. Like, it's a bunch of creeps and a bunch of weirdos out here. And I just want to tell you what you did today.
I mean, could have been gone next second.
I'm glad that you stopped, but I'm also disappointed that you came back. And the reason why I'm glad that you stopped, I'm disappointed that you came back. I mean, I'm disappointed that you came back. But I'm glad that you stopped. And the reason why I'm glad you stopped because I'm able to share this with you.
Right.
You know, but I am disappointed that you got into my car because I'm just a total stranger. And your kids and parents don't know where you're at right now.
Yeah, I don't.
And the last thing that they remember is you probably sending them a text message saying, hey, I'm going to the store.
I'm good.
I'll be back later on. And that's all that they remember. You know. So can you make me a promise? And I know you don't owe me no loyalty, because when you get out this car, you're gonna do what you want to do, as you should. But I'm asking you if you can make me a promise that one would never do that like this again. This is not worth it. This
no, is not worth yeah, it. This really opened my eyes a little bit more, because I could have been gone right now at this second.
It's not worth
anywhere.
It. It's not worth it. It's, Anna, it's not worth it. No amount of money in the world, no nice car, jewelry is worth it, because it could never bring you back. Okay. So I do need you to promise me that you would never do this again.
Definitely not doing this.
Now, one thing I'm not going to ask you to promise me, but I would like to ask you to consider doing it. Would you please share this with somebody? Please share with somebody. Somebody that you care about, even if it's somebody that you don't know. Let them know that it's not okay to talk to strangers or get in their cars. Because even at 30, look at you, they'll still take you. All they care about is what they can make off you. The type of benefits they can make off you by passing you around to the next person. And you're worth more than that, okay?
You're right.
I promise you won't do this again, okay?
I promise I'm not.
All right, I don't want to hold you up. Take care of yourself and keep working hard and take care of your babies, okay?
Yes, sir. I got you.
All right, take care. All right. Very, very, very beautiful lady, man. Fine. But the truth of it is, man, it's like women like that with kids, even women who don't have kids, still at risk. A lot of people I talk to, when I ask them about an Amber Alert, they say the same thing, young kids, young people. But what they don't realize, they are the young people that's been kidnapped and taken out here, man. So I hope that she takes what I told her and share it with somebody, because it's real out here, man. But anyway, I'm out, bro.